I just thought this article was really, I don't know, up to date or something, and quite cool how much they know about the differences of the morphology of the phenotype of these things, their fins and that, as you'll see in the chart at the bottom. I'll go straight to it actually. But then we'll read the chart. See how they have different fins and stuff? They're saying that they operate in different zones, which is pretty interesting. Got like big offshore ones and closer onshore ones, and they have different features on them. I thought they were all the same. And then they prey on different animals as well. And even sperm whales, these ones out in the deep. It's crazy. Some of them, these offshore ones, prey on sharks. That's crazy. See? That's funny. All the TI orcas. That's so funny. And how's this, the next part of this? Wait. The next part. That's crazy, yeah, that the killer whales can take on all the sperm whales. But this part, five days later, like that's, man, they must have signaled, how the fuck did they signal their sperm whale counterparts that far away, is what I was thinking, because 5 days is a long travel, you know what I mean? On the other hand, 5 days later, an attack was foiled. Additional sperm whales arrived to relieve a vulnerable group. Or maybe it was a different group. I thought maybe they meant the same group. And they like called them from that far away. Oops. I'm probably wrong there. That's what I thought the first time I read it. Anyway, yeah.